All right, time for another flight. This time we are in Des Moines and headed to Cedar Rapids. Not 100% familiar with the area. Decided to take off at the regional airport just a little bit north of town. So we're going to head down, cross downtown, do a little loop around Des Moines, and then head up I-80, see what Iowa Speedway looks like. And then eventually get up to Cedar Rapids and maybe see the racetrack up there if I can find it. See what else we've run into. So, let's see what happens. G1000 version, just so that if I need to go outside and look for a while, I can just easily set it to autopilot. You can see downtown. Right now we're going to move over here and catch the highway. Right now, everything up here is AI generated, but as we get about halfway there, everything's going to turn into photogrammetry. But it still looks awesome. So now we're in photogrammetry area. We've got a little industrial area over here. Housing to the left. I think that's still left of the interstate is still AI generated. Just the right is photogrammetry. Train tracks coming through town. Train bends. Come back in. Slowly veering to the right there. Oh, big pause there. Now I don't really have those pauses unless I'm over a photogrammetry city, and also when I'm recording, it doesn't help the issues. We're gonna swing out wide here. Residential area is starting to form up. Up in the sky, that is live traffic, not other users. nice and low and slow. Cool little bridge there. Tons of bridges over the river. Let's not stall it out. Head over to this little area. Looks like an older part of town. Brick buildings.
Just
want to back up. Once you get a little too low, then it's hard to see a lot of things just due to all the trees. Seems to be a ton of trees over here. Yeah, I've only been to Des Moines once, and was at night. And the next day just went to Adventureland. Which we will catch on the way out of town once we start heading east. Got a jet coming in to land at the International. Shouldn't be that close to the flight path. Let's go ahead and put autopilot on. Looks like West Des Moines is the newer area. Got a ton of apartments over here. Lots of shopping centers. I I-80 looping around the north side. Let's go ahead and hop back in. Let's get ourselves headed to the east. Oh my god. I wish you could lock onto that. So it looks like we're far enough north now that we're getting the AI-generated buildings just north of the interstate. So, AI-generated over there. And then photogrammetry down here. Just crazy. I mean, look, you can see the pool for that apartment down there. Got a high school over there, it looks like. And we're just gonna head out on the interstate. I think Adventureland's gonna look that great. I think it's AI generated, so there's gonna be some weird looking buildings trying to figure out what some of the rides are. Trying to see what the logo was on the field there. Can bounce around a little bit. There. Might be a junior high. Football field didn't look as nice. So the lines in the trees that you see there, I think that's just different day, different data, or it's just how it's rendering at a certain distance. I mean, I can live with that when everything looks so amazing. Really used up baseball fields over here. I don't know if they play baseball there anymore. It's like the one that we have in Omaha that is abandoned. What is this building? Big ass plant. Another school over here. But it's AI generated, so not a whole lot of detail, and you can see where the stands are turned into a building. At the airport that we just took off from over there, and now we're gonna head up to Newton. It's down there on the southern part. Just didn't get out to here, so. Hop back out. I believe up here is the amusement park, and then we should have the horse track, but it's definitely all AI generated, so. Some more used up baseball fields, it looks like. I don't know if it's just the season that they took the aerial photos or what. They put some money into it, but probably got a mall here. And that is going to be Adventureland. It's just all buildings. Track, practice track, training track. That is the point. Like they have a woman's prison there. But all those big buildings in this tiny town is the prison. I'm guessing almost everyone that lives in this town probably works or benefits off of that being there. Another big thing is supposed to be an elementary school there. Interstate kind of shoots off to the left to get around. quarry, and then kind of follows the Skunk River. And then after Colfax, we will be at Newton and be able to check out what Iowa Speedway looks like. Snow on the ground here. Snow on the north side of everything that hasn't melted, so probably spring. Two wind turbines over there. High school, looks like they're having a bit of an issue with the hills there. The baseball field and football field have a nice little hill in them. Alright, so straight ahead. So I see the town just a little bit to the left there. There's the airport. Definitely a bunch of snow left on the ground. Hopefully more and more of the country will get some updated summer photography. I don't know how they're going to do the seasons in this game. I know that you can get snow on the ground right now, but it would be interesting to see if they can come up with any colorization thing that would make, you know, a lot of this stuff is going to be green late summer. Generated. We're not going to take too close of a look at that. We're interested to see Iowa Speedway. Looks like we are heading straight at another plane. I'm hoping that they're high up. Now we just go direct to Cedar Rapids and do a little loop around there and then land. Highway 30. They've got quite a bit of a ways to go before we get there. Looks like we've got a town directly in front of us. And I'm going to assume that it's going to be Kellogg. Like it is, it's just on the North Skunk River. And we got Rock Creek Lake just past that. So it's turned its grain bins on the railroad track into buildings and That should just be a big pile of corn that's covered, and it's now a building. So it looks like we're gonna get on path just at the north side of Rock Creek. And we'll go north of Grinnell. And we're gonna be over a ton of farmland. Some random lake in the middle of nowhere, surrounded by houses. Looks like we're gonna go right over it. See, that's what I like about this game. Something I would never see, never explore. And, yeah, find Holiday Lake, which is just surrounded. It's not even a big lake. These houses. Yeah. That is the tiniest lake. Like, everyone's got a dock, too. You can't even do anything on that lake. I wouldn't even call it a lake. Alright. Let's search it, see what the hell the deal is behind this. There's 433 people that live there. Doesn't give any reason on why it exists. I mean, I guess it's somewhat cheap houses under 200,000, but it's also in the middle of nowhere, so some of those houses might be worth a lot more if they were near civilization. You'll see what I'm talking about when we get there. But it is absolutely in the middle of nowhere. I lived on a bigger lake. I mean, it wasn't a big lake, but for Nebraska, it's a fairly big lake that you can water ski on and not run into everyone if you tried to do anything with this lake. I don't think you could even ski on. So that's Grinnell. Got a college in town. There'll be a golf course on the north side of town. Not sure if we'll be able to see it or not. Yeah, I think it's that really, really dark area over there. front of us is Big Bear Creek. Running across there. Another thing I love about this, and this is just probably from being from Nebraska, is all the other games, like country roads, would usually end up being like paved. Now they still look horrible since they put this stupid texture over them, but at least at a distance they look like a country road. All the way throughout here is around we had a 1494, just a little pop up in the elevation over here, but it looks like it flats back or goes a little lower around the Iowa River. Directly ahead, looks like we got some trees, which usually means civilization, and I think that is the lake I've been complaining about. Yep, so that's the lake there. Valley that was flooded. A farm area. Do wish that they didn't turn everything into houses. You could figure out what a barn is. Looks like it's kind of okay. Highway 63, that little chunk of buildings there is called Sheridan. Might be a field that it thought was buildings. Oh no, those are actual buildings. Fremont Farms. Looking like probably a pig farm. Alright, coming up on a lake that's not a lake. Like, you can't even barely see any water there. Sorry if you're one of the 490 whatever I said people that live here, but seems very pointless. Okay. kind of see right up there the valley for the river. You got the hills on the other side and the hills that we're on. This a lake. Nowhere. Look around here. Ton of houses, though. Lots of boats. I don't even know, like, why would you want them? I'm just so confused. I could see, like, a canoe or something. Boat, you're never even gonna get it out of idle. Alright, figure out where we're headed next. Looks like we got an airport on the map. That is gonna be Belle Plaine. Just north of the river. We're gonna be crossing over. It's like a wildlife management area. Randolph Wildlife. Missing quite a few trees around the river there. I assume there's a lot of trees along that. Looks like there should be. clear, though. Clouds moving in central Iowa. Railroad and highway not even the railroad just takes its own path. There's not even a road that goes along with it for a bit, kind of squares off for a while and then it goes with it. Yeah, lots of missing trees down there. Like, it wants to put them there because it's put some there, but it's having a. It's not putting enough. Flatland, although anyone not from Nebraska or Iowa or even Kansas would probably think that we've been flying over flatland the whole time. Amazingly, we haven't ran into any AI-generated land where it gets a cloud and wants to cover it up. See, these hills are fairly large compared to the houses. Then you get over here into the river valley. Nice flat area, hills all around it. Obviously, years and years of erosion, flooding, kind of flattens things out. Alright, time to figure out where I'm at now. Oh, you know what? I was looking at the wrong area to begin with. Railroad track, so we're still on the Iowa River, and that is going to be Marengo. Pretty sure. that little reservoir right there on the north side of town. Something. Now we're starting to get lots of little towns scattered all over. So directly down from the pig farm is going to be Watkins. Yeah, it looks like it's Watkins. Just peeking out there. Is Watkins, tiny, tiny town. Railroad goes through it though. Let's see what the population of that place is. Watkins is 118 people. That is Norway, just going behind the pillar there. And then we got Wolford directly in front of us. And that should put where we're headed. There's the airport directly in front of us. Take nav off. We don't want to go there right away. Let's go see what Cedar Rapids looks like. Slightly up north here. See if I can get us a nice little angle to check out the racetrack first. Looks like we're headed right there. That's 151 going into town there, I believe. And then this is the railroad. Airport there, so the racetrack should be right across Highway 30 there. Not sure if this will be photogrammetry from here. It's not looking like it. Normally it's a more brown color from a distance. 12 to 15. It's a little higher on the other side of the river. Looks like everything's gonna be AI generated here. Almost an hour into this flight. Missing a few trees along the river still. But for AI generated, doesn't look too terrible. It's not right here. Downtown's gonna look a little odd. The racetrack's probably really odd. Track just ahead. Massive building. It's like General Mills and another warehouse right there. Lined that up perfect to hit the racetrack. So yeah, everything's AI generated here. Hopefully towns this size will eventually get flown over to get the photogrammetry. A big old mess of stuff down there. Yeah, I did fairly good. Not making it look like a total mess. And the multiple ovals inside ovals inside ovals. There's like a BMX track just outside of that. There we go, Cedar Rapids. So we'll loop around downtown. Like I said, downtown's gonna look a little odd with AI generated. I've noticed that buildings are usually slightly too tall. High school down there, maybe a junior high, not a whole lot of markings on the fields. The river's not screwed up here, like the Missouri. I think it's also really lacking trees. Normally you can't see this many buildings. Yeah, it's definitely not putting trees. Well, now it is. It's starting to fill it in as we get closer. It's very odd that to be able to see that many houses that clearly. That this town is very brown, brick brown, with the AI. Lots of little different parts of town, though. It's like, it's a whole different town up there. And it looks like it extends out on 380.
Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha is 11 miles north with Mike to land.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha Cedar Rapids Tower. Fly left base runway 13. Altimeter 29er decimal 85 wing 187 at 12.
Fly left base runway 13 Cessna Golf Sierra Alpha.
Stuff all throughout this, but just bigger airports it helps to do. Pretty big hills there, right along the river, keeping it in its place. Happening there. Is there a highway there? Maybe it's a new highway. Yeah, looks like it. So the photography doesn't match up with the road maps. I assume that's what's going on there. I love how difficult it is to spot the runways. This up right. We got another elementary school or something that uses that same design. I'm sure they were thinking about that. What it looks like from the air. Probably going to be pretty bad.
Golf Sierra Alpha cleared to land runway 13. Wind 187 at 12. Cleared to land runway 13, Cessna Golf Sierra Alpha.
Trailer park down there. Got any lights to help me not screw this up and be too low? Still having a hard time judging the angle. No, we're general.
Rabbit Tower, generic November 121 Lima Whiskey, 2-6 miles east inbound, Arnav runway 13 approach. Generic November 121 Lima Whiskey, Cedar Rapids Tower. Cleared Arnav runway 13 approach. Altimeter 29 decimal 85 wind 187 at 12.
I did not spot those lights in time. Very hot approach.
Cleared Arnav runway 13 approach, generic 1 Lima Whiskey.
not even close to a good landing, but we're on the ground safe at least. Not going to take me to general aviation.
Golf, Sierra Alpha, contact ground on 121.6.
121.6, Cessna Golf, Sierra Alpha.
This looks like... Let me quickly look and see where it looks like general aviation would be. Flight training, FedEx. This is... State of Iowa stuff, so looks like we are going actually back across.
Ground Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha taxi to parking.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Alpha taxi to general aviation parking using taxiway Alpha cross runway 27 Alpha.
Taxiing to general aviation parking via taxiway Alpha cross runway 27 Alpha Cessna Golf Sierra Alpha.
Alright. More lights in the middle. The terminal here, obviously all AI generated. I feel like that hangar's a bit big. Now I did hear another plane coming in. I'm just gonna stay on this taxiway. They do actually have general in the correct area, it looks like. Then over there's flight training and FedEx. And turn off here. Just gonna be at a weird angle, I guess. And there we go. The parking brake on. Cut the engine. Didn't have my landing lights on. Don't start it. There we go. End of flight. It was a bit of a long one. 1 hour and 11. But, yeah, hopefully that covered a few areas. And hopefully you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.